Hi, welcome to the Gamesplainer. I'm Jeff the Gamesplainer, and today I'm gamesplaining Azul. In the game of Azul, we are trying to put coloured tiles, which are these tokens here, onto our wall. The way in which we do that is fairly simple. The first player will choose one of the sections of wall that are available. We'll take everything of that colour and place it somewhere on the left-hand side of their board. Everything else that is left in the wall is then put into the center. The next person can do the same. They can choose anything they wish, etc. around the circle. You're taking all of whichever color you're choosing to take. If someone has gone for that, the next person, maybe they want those orange ones. So they can take the three orange from the center, but they also get that minus 1 point. What that also does is gives them the first player marker for next turn, but it gives them a negative point. If a player were to take too many tiles for the place they wish to put it, so say he wishes to put it here, he has an extra tile, that one cannot be put onto an extra row. It needs to be then be put down the bottom, which will give negative points at the end of the round. And the round continues like that until all of the tiles are gone from this setup up the top. Then we hit the second phase of what we're doing. And the second phase is getting some points. So what you're scoring is, you go from the top down, any line that has completed the pattern line, so that's that area on the left, you will be able to move them across. So this one will be able to move those three across. Over here, he'll move those three across. So we go from the top first. So one tile by itself is worth 1 point. This tile will go here. So this is worth 2 points because we have a line of two tiles. So he gets another 2 points. This one goes here, which is worth just the 1 point again. Now, the rest of these tiles that were in the pattern lines from where they've come will now get discarded into the lid of the box for future use. So I'll do the same over here. So that's 1 point for the blue because it's by itself. 1 point for that one because it's by itself. And 1 point for that one also because it's by itself. They then get thrown into the box lid. These ones stay in their position, in their location. Any tiles that you have down the bottom get you a minus point. So this guy gets minus 1 point, and that tile then goes into the box lid. And this guy gets minus one point, and that tile goes back into the middle for the next round. We then put four more tiles onto each of the locations, and we go for the second round. It's as simple as that. Where this game starts getting really hard and heavy is I cannot put a blue tile there, simply because I already have that blue tile arranged. So blue can't go in that top at all. And that's the same case on any of the rows. If this player in the next turn happened to get red, the red would go in. The way that would get scored is you get 2 points for the horizontal line and then another 3 points for the vertical line. So that would actually be worth 5 points for him to get that. The game finishes once someone has at least one row complete. So it's going to be a minimum of 5 rounds, probably a 6 or 7, but at least 5 rounds because there are 5 and you can only do one tile per round. At the end of the game, so finishing once someone has a complete row of the 5, you will get 2 points for every row of those 5 that you have. So some people are able to get a couple of those rows. Multiple people will likely get the rows on the same turn. You'll then get 7 points for each vertical row that is completed. And then you also get 10 points for each color that is on all 5 rows. Whoever is at the front is the winner of the game. And that is Azul. That is how to play it. There is a variation on the game that is the other side of these boards. You notice that the right-hand side is all grey. That means that any colour, they don't have to go on their specific colours. They can go anywhere on that board, or at least within the line that you've filled up. Just remembering that in each horizontal and each vertical line, you can only have one of each colour. Otherwise, it plays exactly the same. And so if you have filled up a space with a colour that can't actually go on that line because the colour is already there, all of the tiles will then go onto the bottom, which will give you negative points. And that is Azul. If you have any comments or suggestions, please write them below. If you have any games that you wish to be Gamesplained, please shoot me an email at thegamesplainer@gmail.com. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at thegamesplainer to keep up to date with the games that I'm playing. Subscribe to my videos to keep up to date with the games that I'm gamesplaining. And until next time, enjoy gaming.